Hey gang, Energyone here. How are you enjoying the resource revamp so far? That feature had been delayed 5 or 6 times, and no doubt more changes will be coming down the road. It makes me wonder though, do nanites make you itch? There have been an obvious increase in vehicle combat, which I think is a good thing for the most part. However, my initial feeling is that maxes might still need some tweaking. SOE has already increased resource costs on the max, but only time will tell if it will be enough. I intended to have way more content uploaded, but I was in the hospital for almost a week due to a bug bite that gave me a nasty cellulitis infection, with IVs sticking out everywhere like I was a human pincushion. Hey, at least I got to have some pretty nurses serving my every whim, right? Right? Yeah! Anyways, the Valkyrie is on test, but I'm waiting for it to get a few updates as it's in a very raw form. I also keep hearing how awful the Spiker pistol is and that everyone is recommending to never buy it without some changes. Now, hopefully that's a very effective way of initiating change. Obviously, Sony wants to sell new weapons, and if there is threads, tweets, and videos out there telling people to not spend money on it due to bad design, maybe they'll take a second look. The directive system is pretty cool, and if anything, I've just enjoyed watching new types of video montages for weapons we don't normally see due to it. I've been messing with the Skorpios SMG on the VS side, and I can't really complain. I really wish it had a suppressor, but it won't stop me from using it. It just feels like a better Eridani, which is the hardest hitting SMG available to the Vanu if you didn't spend any certs for attachments. Personally though, it seems game performances were simply due to the forced lattice and mission system. Everyone gets jammed in the same couple of regions and the server chokes on it every single day, with people warping in, delayed class abilities, and so on. Last night, for example, I died several times simply due to the fact that my cloak would react seconds after I clicked it and started attempting to shoot at targets. You can see how medkits react when the server is like this every single day. It's not on my end. No one is using the net during this time and I have a 64 connection. Ping has little to do with these particular issues, even though it affects performance. Now last week, Thursday, Ultra Street Fighter 4 finally came to the PC, which was a day earlier than announced. I'm trying to pick up Hugo, but I still enjoy messing around with El Fuerte. Netcode has been up and down, but patches are on the way. If you live in the US, send me a message and we can practice against each other sometime perhaps. I've taken a break from Diablo 3 only because I'm waiting for patch 2.1, which is filled with a lot of goodies. Even though I think the legendary gem upgrade system is kind of a joke. Oh, and hey, Witch Doctor fans, we are finally getting a fetish counter after all these years. Yay! Hopefully it'll be on live by the end of the month. Due to this, I have not been streaming on top of my health issues, but maybe I will stream some Street Fighter in the meantime, depending on how the netcode works out. Our Twitch stream is listed on the About section of the channel page, along with Twitter details and all of that other stuff that helps get me more creepy stalkers. Mortal Kombat X is starting to look pretty good, but we need to stress that all footage so far is from development on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One versions. The PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 versions are being ported by other third-party companies and is not being handled in-house at NetherRealm. It's very likely going to be the same if it comes to PC. Now, I've had requests for another Be Less Derp episode explaining the directives, the mission system, and resource revamp. But does anyone still care anymore at this point? I've been unavailable when the release of an episode would have been timely due to health issues, and by now I would think most know all of what the information would contain in such an episode. Let me know in the comments section, and before I forget, belated happy birthday to my wife of 9 years who goes by the nickname Tasmo online. She turned another year awesome on August 12th, and instead of picking on her regarding the addition of more gray hair, I'll purposely be corny and make others sick to their stomach by saying how much I can't wait to grow old with you, cutie.
Thanks for watching our video and subscribe to Energy One. Learn how to be less derp with Channel Energy One.